subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
You're watching Tag TV.
India is well known around the world owing to its historical background, diverse cultures and interesting traditions. Its ancient scriptures and texts have been the way of life of its people for thousands of years. Today, the country is taking huge strides in various fields like arts and science, paving a way towards a progressive India. So friends, I'm your host Shreyasa Vijay, and today in our episode of My India, we'll take a look at some of the stories that very well showcase the unique culture and prosperity of our country, stretching from Himalayas to Kanyakumari. Celebrated in the bright half of the Hindu calendar month Ashwin, which typically falls in the Gregorian months of September and October. Navratri is one of the most revered festivals in Hinduism, though observed for different reasons and celebrated differently across various parts of the country. The core reason behind the celebration remains the same, that is, victory of good over evil. So, today in our series of culture stories, let's have a look at this year's Navratri celebrations as the country is returning back to normal amid the pandemic.
People across the country got soaked in a number of festivities as the Navratri festival kicked off. The Hindu festival, which spans up to 9 nights and 10 days, is celebrated differently in various parts of the Indian cultural sphere. The northern and western belt leads to the enactment of a beautiful dramatic folk play, Ram Leela, that celebrates the victory of Lord Rama over the demon king Ravana. This year, because of the pandemic, Ram Leela was streamed on online platforms so as to avoid the crowd as a safety measure during the pandemic. Meanwhile, in the eastern and northeastern states, people set up beautifully decorated pandals, which are temporary structure erected on land for Durga Puja celebrations observed on the last 5 days of Navratri. This year, migrant themed pandal set up in Kolkata city of West Bengal was hogging limelight for its unique depiction of the plight of migrants during lockdown.
Lot of pains they have faced, so yet they have came back to their home, they have came back to their mother, they have come back to their family, but yet they are facing a lot of problem. So I have made this theme, this about migrant labor, to put in the eyes of a public that we have to stand with them yet now.
Much enthusiasm was witnessed in the capital city, New Delhi, where devotees dressed up in crisp new clothes thronged the beautifully decorated temples to make the offering to the goddess and pray for the well-being of their loved ones. Meanwhile, the Vaishno Devi Shrine in Jammu and Kashmir's Katra town saw a mild rush of pilgrims offering prayers and singing hymns due to the pandemic.
कोरोना का अरेंजमेंट है, मतलब डिस्टेंस मेंटेन्ड है और इतना क्राउड नहीं था. मोर ओवर यू कैन काउंट पीपल.
मीनवाइल इन कोयंबटूर सिटी ऑफ तमिलनाडु, गोलू इज ऑर्गेनाइज्ड अराउंड द नवरात्रि फेस्टिवल. इट इज बेसिकली अ फेस्टिव डिस्प्ले ऑफ डॉल्स एंड फिगरीन्स इन साउथ इंडिया typically made by rural artisans from clay and local materials than brightly painted. These lifelike dolls depict episodes from the lives of Lord Ganesha, Krishna, Rama and many more. Though every year thousands of artisans participate in the exhibition to showcase their work, however, this time amid the pandemic, the exhibition remained a low-key affair.
Compared to the last year, this year the artisans' flows are very less. Last year there was nearly 20 artisans, this year there were only 15 artisans who have participated in the exhibition. This year in Kolu, we have paper mache dolls and we have matchstick based toys and etikup toys, Varanasi toys and other crafts, and we have mixed here with models. There are certain types of models here. This year we have highlighted the Ramar Koil temple is the highlighted temple model in this year.
In other parts of the country too, the festival was marked with fasting, feasting, prayers and several other celebrations. The festival holds immense importance in Hinduism and is believed that during this time, Goddess Durga descends on earth to get rid of demons and blesses her children with happiness and prosperity.
India has remained a land of great saints, assimilating in its fold various cultures and faiths from time to time. It is a land where Sufism has not only flourished in its true spirit, but has also become a way of integrating different religious communities. A glimpse of it can be witnessed at the shrine of Hazrat Baba, located in the hilly town of Shimla in Himachal Pradesh, where people from different religions come to pay homage. Take a look.
The shrine of Hazrat Baba in the hill town of Shimla is serving as a cynosure of unification among myriad faiths practiced in India for nearly a century now. Devotees, irrespective of their caste and faith, throng the shrine and offer their respect to the revered Sufi saint and pray for the well-being of their family.
This is a country where all religion people live, and everyone should live like one community. They should not involve in getting divided.
Sufi Saint Hazrat Baba was a renowned figure among the people of Shimla, and currently his shrine is taken care by a Hindu trust. Located in an area with about 93% of Hindu population, the shrine also has a Hindu caretaker, which clearly showcases camaraderie among the people of different faiths residing in the region.
मैं इस तरह से यहाँ आया तो जब मुझे पता चला कि ये कौन सी कम्युनिटी इसको मेंटेन कर रही है तो बहुत ज़्यादा खुशी हुई है और हम भी चाहेंगे कि तमाम इंडिया में मुसलमान हिंदू या तमाम रिलीजन के लोग एक साथ मिलकर रहें और आपस में भाईचारा हो और हम लोग इनको मानते हैं और यहाँ पे हम दुआ करते हैं वो हमें यकीन है कि वो अल्लाह की बारगाह में जाती है और कबूल होती है और उसमें जो हिंदूज आते हैं उनको भी ये भरोसा है कहीं ना कहीं कि हम दुआ मांगेंगे तो ये अल्लाह के वली हैं और ये हमारे लिए अगर इनकी नज़र पड़ गई तो हमारा काम हो जाएगा
The Sufi saints like Baba Hazrat have always propagated the message of spiritualism and harmony in our country, and the teachings are still playing a significant role in binding different faiths together.
Now, a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently. Authorities have organized autumn festival in Pehelgam town of Jammu and Kashmir's Anantnag district to boost tourism amid the coronavirus pandemic. The two-day festival organized by the Jammu and Kashmir Tourism Department aimed to revive the industry through art, craft, music, handicrafts and food.
हमारी कोशिश है कि जो यहाँ टूरिज़्म का रिवाइवल है बहुत ज़रूरी है, हमारी इकानमी का डेवलपमेंट बहुत ज़रूरी इस पर मुनासर है। इसके साथ साथ 25-30% लोग कश्मीर के हैं, जम्मू कश्मीर के हैं, जो इस टूरिज़्म के साथ वाबस्ता है। आपको पता है पिछले तकरीबन 6 महीने से तक पूरा ठप ही पड़ा था बिकॉज ऑफ कोविड, लेकिन अब हमने छोड़ दिया है टूरिज़्म का रिवाइवल के लिए, हर एकदम कोशिश की जा रही है।
The Kashmir Valley is a popular destination among tourists from across the world who are drawn to its Himalayan summits and treks along with picturesque valleys and lakes. However, the coronavirus pandemic has restricted people to their homes and most of them are avoiding traveling due to the fear of contracting the disease.
An awareness campaign named Red Light On Gaadi Off, meaning red light on the vehicle off, was recently launched by the Chief Minister of New Delhi, Arvind Kejriwal. As the part of the campaign, people were encouraged to turn off their car's engine while waiting at red light signals to fight pollution in the city. Volunteers at the traffic signals asked commuters to turn off their vehicles and contribute to the cause. Violators were given red roses to raise awareness.
Red light पे अपनी गाड़ी को off कीजिए, इससे हमें भी फायदा है और दिल्ली को भी फायदा है कि हमारा तेल बचेगा और दिल्ली के लिए ये फायदा है कि प्रदूषण कम होगा.
With winter approaching and stubble being burned in neighboring states of Haryana and Punjab, air quality in New Delhi has started to plummet, making life difficult for its residents who are already dealing with the coronavirus pandemic.
The Indian states of Uttar Pradesh, Punjab and Sikkim partially reopened schools after over 6 months of coronavirus lockdown. Last month, the federal government had issued guidelines allowing states to decide to gradually reopen schools, colleges and other educational institutions from October 15 at 50% capacity, adhering to COVID-19 safety measures.
मुझे बहुत खुशी हो रही है कि मैं 7 महीने बाद मैं स्कूल आ रहा हूँ और ये 7 महीने बहुत मुश्किल से मैंने निकाले हैं. घर पे मतलब पढ़ा भी नहीं जाता था, स्कूल में आके एक आदत सी थी कि पढ़ना है और स्कूल में अच्छा पढ़ा जाता है.
लोकल टेलीविजन शोड स्टूडेंट्स इन फेस मास्क, वॉशिंग देयर हैंड्स विद सैनिटाइजर एंड अंडरगोइंग बॉडी टेम्परेचर चेक्स before attending classes in the northern states of Uttar Pradesh and Punjab. Social distancing also appeared to be enforced in classrooms.
In order to aware youngsters about drug abuse in a unique way, a music concert was recently organized in Srinagar city of Jammu and Kashmir. Musicians through their renditions tried to spread a message among the audience that they should stay away from the drugs as it can finish their lives.
Oh, I'm saying, The singers in Kashmir are already welcoming a number of youngsters in their band or music groups so as to channelize their energy in creative activities and help them stay away from drug addiction.
Displaying mutual tolerance and having regards for each other's beliefs forms the foundation of the Indian culture. Even today, several examples can be found across the nook and corner of the country who are keeping this culture intact. The latest one to join this list is Rohit Srivastav from Lucknow city of Uttar Pradesh, who has set a milestone of Hindu-Muslim camaraderie by donating money for the building of Ayodhya Mosque. Have a look.
No matter how many religions we practice in India, but in a sense, they all are one. Every religion teaches us to respect the other and be kind and generous to everyone in the universe. Depicting the same principles, a Hindu man in Lucknow city donated an amount of Rs. 21,000 for the construction of the mosque complex in Ayodhya, also becoming the first one to make the contribution. A law faculty employee of Lucknow University, Rohit Srivastav, handed over the amount to Indo-Islamic Cultural Foundation, a trust constituted by the Sunni Waqf Board to oversee the construction of the mosque complex.
मुझे लगा कि एक ऐसा काम करना चाहिए जो एकता भाईचारे का संदेश जो कि लखनऊ की हमारी गंगा जमुनी तहजीब है उसको हम कुछ ना करके एक संदेश ऐसा दें कि आगे जो युवा आजकल का हमारा भटका हुआ है किसी भी समाज का हो वो इससे कुछ प्रेरित होके ऐसा काम वो भी करे कि जिससे हमारा आपसी सौहार्द हमेशा कायम रहे.
The complex that will comprise of a mosque, library, museum and a community kitchen will be built on the 5 acres of land given to Muslim community in Thanipur village of Ayodhya, about 25 kilometers from the Ram Janmabhoomi complex. The mosque will measure around 15,000 square feet and will be square shaped like Kaaba Sharif in Mecca. The people of Ayodhya are effusive in their praises of Rohit Srivastav for his donation and presenting a perfect example of Hindu-Muslim brotherhood to the society.
Srivastav ji ka main tahe dil se shukriya ada karta hu aur unhone Ganga Jamuni tehzeeb ki achhi misal pesh ki hai. Ayodhya ki sarzameen pe aaj tak jitne bhi hamare yahan program hote hain chahe wo urs ho chahe 12 Rabiul Awwal ka program ho yahan Hindu aur Musalman dono samudaye जिस तरीके से जिसकी आबादी है उस हिसाब से बढ़ चढ़ करके हिस्सा लेते हैं, लंगर करवाते हैं, भंडारा करवाते हैं. दुर्गा पूजा में मुसलमान लोग जो है मूर्तियों पे फूल बरसाते हैं. 12 रबीउल अव्वल में हमारे कौस्तुभ मणियाचार्य जी और तमाम लोग जो हैं वो हमारे 12 रबीउल अव्वल में सद्भावना का संदेश देते हुए मुसलमानों का उनके अंजुमनों का स्वागत करते हैं.
पीपल लाइक रोहित are not just an inspiration for the society to rise above religious biases, but also play an important role in strengthening the bond of oneness among various faiths.
Indian trials for Russia's Sputnik V vaccine are soon going to start in the next few weeks. The Indian firm, Dr. Reddy's Laboratories, will conduct phase 3 studies, pursue regulatory approvals and, subject to approval, distribute the finished vaccine product in the country. Along with them, one more pharma company has signed an agreement for the sales and distribution of the Russian vaccine, and these developments are believed to bring India a step closer to potentially getting a COVID-19 vaccine by the end of this year. We bring you a report.
Amid rising numbers of infected COVID-19 cases in the world, the Russian Federation in August announced the approval of the first vaccine of the coronavirus, Sputnik V, which is based on vectors of human adenoviruses. the Russia Direct Investment Fund or RDIF, which is piloting Sputnik V candidate vaccine, has partnered with the Hyderabad-based Dr. Reddy's Laboratories to conduct Phase 3 trials in India. Around 1,000 to 2,000 participants will be enrolled and the trials will be conducted at multiple government and private hospitals across the country.
According to the World Health Organization database, about 43 vaccines have already come into clinical evaluation, and almost like 150 candidates' vaccines are in preclinical evaluation. And it is heartening to note that scientists of both our great nations, that is India and Russia, have made significant progress in this endeavor. We should congratulate Russian scientists for getting two vaccines into the commercialization phase. And from the Indian side, if you look at the Indian scientists are also working very hard, and we should also congratulate them for getting at least three vaccines to advance clinical evaluation phase.
Dr. Reddy's Laboratories, or DRL, has also received regulatory approval from the Drugs Controller General of India to conduct mid to late stage human trials of Russia's vaccine candidate in India. Once testing is completed and approvals are granted, RDIF will supply around 100 million doses of Sputnik V to DRL. Currently, the vaccine is also undergoing phase 3 trials in Russia with a proposed number of 40,000 subjects.
Мы отобрали специально добровольцев, тех, которые достаточно молодые, чтобы им было не больше 40, но, может быть, до 50 лет и без сопутствующих заболеваний, потому что сама прививка не имеет еще такой срок давности, срок проверки. И сейчас в Москве и во всех городах проводится третья стадия клинических испытаний. Поэтому вызовет у привитых болезнь коронавируса или не вызовет, еще пока не совсем ясно. Поэтому брали молодежь, которая, даже если заболеет коронавирусной инфекцией, она должна ее перенести достаточно легко.
Meanwhile, a Delhi-based Mankind Pharma has also collaborated with RDIF for marketing and distribution of Sputnik V in India. The doses of vaccines supplied in India will likely be a combination of Indian and Russian-made doses. RDIF has also reached agreements with Indian manufacturers to produce 300 million doses of the shot in India.
That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at mindia@nin.com. I'm your host, Shreya Savitya, and it's goodbye from the entire production team.